going to talk about Labyrinth, one of my favorite movies when I was a child. This movie starts with Sarah, something like that, played by baby Jennifer Connelly, and she starts by live-action RPGing in the park with her dog, because she has no friends and she's a sad little nerd.
That's how people had fun in the 80s, I guess.
Then she remembers she needs to get home to babysit her annoying half-brother, and the rain starts. Her parents are like the most average parents ever. They ask her if she can babysit little twat, and he's crying, and somehow it stole a plushie, even if he can walk, and he's like a jerk for her, so she has a temper tantrum over the fact that she has to babysit him. Poor little Sarah. Life is so hard when you're a teenager and you have a little brother. Whatever. She starts talking to herself for some reason, and just out of the blue there are some goblins around, and in waiting for her to say the right thing, something like, "Goblin King, Goblin King, can you steal this baby? I hate it, I don't care anymore." At that point, an owl goes through the window and it poofs and it transforms into David Bowie. Yeah, David Bowie. I mean, Jareth, the Goblin King. He's like just there, standing around. They have a little interaction.
"Oh, hi. I'm a powerful and older male figure. I'm here to confuse the shit out of you. Also, I'll take this baby."
And he takes the baby. She goes through the labyrinth while weird things happen, and she meets creatures. None of them help. And goes collecting all the side characters.
"And I cheat."
The side characters she comes across are a grumpy little dwarf with a running gag. And a silly comic relief with a dog. Don't forget that you have a David Bowie and puppets, and so you need to use them. You need to have music, all the music, very, very catchy music. You even have a little fever dream sequence by an evil peach, and there are masks and romantic music and dancing and puffy dresses, very, very, very puffy dresses. It's really wrong. After that fever sequence and a growing up allegory, they start the final showdown. They go into the center of the labyrinth, fight the goblins of the Goblin King, and they win because magic rocks. Course. And she for some reason decides that she needs to go alone against the Goblin King, and goes and roams around in stairs while he confesses his love for her.
"But I love you."
After that she stands against him and she replays the lines of her LARPing, and for some reason they work.
"Lol, no."
Then she gets back to reality and everything seems to be a dream, except that it isn't. They start a dance party and lots of fanfics occur. Well, that's mostly what happens in Labyrinth. It's one of my favorite movies and you should watch it if you haven't already. The puppetry is beautiful, everything's weird, and there is a lot of amazing catchy music. It's really funny. For this video I used the voice of one of my friends, so thanks to him for helping me and motivating me to do it. I need to do more of these things and more of the other things and more of all the things. I guess I'll try it. Best thing I can promise. Well, thank you for watching this short little thingy. I hope you liked it and have a great day today.